Hey guys, the Ampro 2 was one of the most interesting pre-built 60% mechanical keyboard for me this year. It is super affordable considering all the features you get, and the quality is pretty nice. But at $80, it might still be a bit steep for someone's first 60% board. You might be unsure if you'll like the layout, if you'll get used to it, or if you'll miss some of the missing dedicated keys. Well, the Velocifier Mini might be the keyboard for you. This little guy features real mechanical switches, it has a standard NC layout, it is wireless, and it features a pretty good quality, especially considering the price. And all of that for only $37 as of filming this video. Pretty impressive, right? Well, let's see what this is all about. The keyboard comes in an unbranded brown box. In it, you will find the keyboard itself and a micro USB cable to charge it. You also get a keycap puller and four additional red keycaps for WASD. These keycaps are painted, so I'd expect them to show somewhere pretty fast, and they're made from ABS plastic too. Taking a look at the keyboard, it features an NC layout, which is a nice touch if you want to get into 60% keyboards. It has pretty much the same dimensions as a Poker or the Ampro, and the case has a really similar angle too. Under the case, you will find a spot to store the wireless USB dongle. There are also four rubber pads and an on-off switch, which is a great way to maintain battery life when you don't use it. The keyboard has two micro USB ports. Both are only meant for charging, as this keyboard is wireless and wireless only. This is a bit of a con, as it's nice to have a wired option to use in your BIOS or in special cases where you can use the dongle, but I'll get into that later. Having two micro USB ports, you can route the wire one way or the other quite easily. The keycaps are ABS, but they are double shot, which is pretty nice. ABS is not desirable as it will shine over time, but double shot keycaps have their legend made out of a different colored plastic, which means it will never wear down. That's a nice touch at such a low price. Many won't necessarily buy a third-party keycap set, as it'll cost almost as much as the keyboard itself in a lot of cases. The switches are Audemu, and I went with Browns. They're a bit stiffer than Cherry or Gateron equivalents at 55 grams. And overall, they feel slightly more mushy, I think. They're pretty good overall, and I haven't had any problems with them yet, but my Cherry Browns do feel a bit smoother. They don't stick, and I feel like their actuation force is even across the board. They also have a clear housing, although they don't have any form of LED lights under, apart from the caps lock and function keys. Considering the price of the board, these switches are quite amazing. It's an overall pleasant typing experience, and I think it will beat most other keyboards in the same price range. I've had worse typing experiences than that. As an example, the original Ampro. This one had really bad stabilizers, while this little keyboard has decent ones. Not as great as Cherry stabilizers or some of the good third-party ones, but still pretty good and not an issue at all. One great thing is that the stabilizers are standard too, which means you can still replace the keycaps if you want to. And these are mounted on a metal plate, which adds a lot of strength to the board. In fact, the flex is not too bad and it has a decent weight too. It crackles a bit, but I didn't expect much for such a low price. Now, that layout is standard, but the second layer is not exactly the same as most popular 60% boards out there. First, the function key is not at its typical location, although it's not too far at the bottom right corner. Then the arrow keys are accessed by combining the function keys and the Alt, Windows, Control, and question mark keys at the right of the board. This is not typical, but we see this layout often on cheaper 60% keyboards. However, most advanced 60% keyboard users prefer to use the function plus WASD or IJKL. I'm personally more used to the WASD way, but this arrow key layout is not bad either, and it's only a matter of getting used to it. In fact, it might be slightly easier to pick up for typical arrow key users, as it's located pretty close to where arrow keys typically are. The function row is standard, same thing for the tilt key. And the second layer cannot be reprogrammed for something else, which I did expect at that price, but it's still an aspect to consider when buying this keyboard. You need to like the layout and the layers as they are. Also, other keys like home, page down, insert, and others will not be accessible with this board. The function keys LEDs will let you know if the battery is charged when it's red, When it turns off, it means that the battery is full. It will also flash blue when the battery is low. And while the keyboard is wireless only, you can still use it while charging it, and that's convenient. As for the quality of the wireless signal, this little guy uses a dongle instead of Bluetooth like we see in most of the wireless 60% boards nowadays. This results in limited features, such as not connecting to multiple devices at once and no connection to most tablets and phones either. On the other hand, the connection has been rock solid with no noticeable lag. It's one of the best, if not the best, typing experience I've had with a wireless mechanical keyboard up to now. The AN Pro 2 does work really well, but you do get really occasional and temporary slowdowns and slight delays when reconnecting after sleep. But this one has been perfect since the first time I've tried it. Even for casual gaming, it was responsive enough to not be a problem. Again, I'm no pro gamer, and if you want the best experience, you should always use the wired keyboard, but for some couch gaming or slow-paced games, I think it would do just fine. I was not really able to tell the difference between my wired keyboard and this one, and the range is not as good as Bluetooth. I was starting to get latencies and missed strokes at about 15 feet from the dongle. It's plenty good, but you might want to consider it for a home theater PC, depending on how far you'll be. And I could probably get better results by having the dongle in sight instead of hidden behind my PC as well. As for the battery life, Velocifier claim over 1000 hours, but I think they're talking about the standby mode. In my case, I only charged it once and I still haven't yet, which is pretty impressive. I used it for about 3 to 4 hours a day for over a week, and I even forgot to turn it off for a whole day once. When that happens with my AN Pro 2, usually it's dead the day after. And before ending this video, here is a little sound comparison against the Velocifier Mini featuring Audemu Brown switches, a Poker with Cherry Brown switches, and an AN Pro 2 with Kale Brown switches. So, in conclusion, who should consider this keyboard? If you're new to the 60% mechanical keyboard market and you're unsure if you'll like it, I think it's a good place to start without investing too much. You'll get a lot of the core features most 60% keyboards have, and you'll get a great typing experience too. And you will also see if you get used to using the function key to access some of the missing keys. And it could help you making a better decision if you want to upgrade to a nicer 60% board someday. This unit would be really great as a home theater PC controller too, as it's pretty compact and it's wireless. It's really cheap and very comparable to other non-mechanical wireless keyboard options on the market, and the quality of the wireless signal is excellent. And finally, it would be great for some couch gaming. Gaming on a TV already introduces some latency, so the added latency of the wireless signal wouldn't ruin the experience too much, I think. Also, the 60% layout has all the keys you would need for most games. On the other hand, if you're a mechanical keyboard enthusiast, you might feel like this keyboard misses a few key features. You can't remap the keys, there's no wired mode, and there are no LEDs either. But you know, to offer a great keyboard at such a low price, some corners have to be cut. Also, if you're a hardcore gamer, having no wired mode is kind of a deal breaker, because even though it's a pretty good wireless signal, it could introduce some lag or some misstrokes at times. And finally, if you're often on the go and want to use the keyboard across multiple devices, I would suggest to go with a Bluetooth mechanical keyboard instead of one with a dongle like this one. They're a lot more flexible and can connect to a variety of peripherals such as tablets and phones, and even laptops that don't necessarily have a dedicated full-size USB port nowadays. So with a Bluetooth connectivity instead, you would enjoy using the keyboard a lot more, I think. But apart from that, the keyboard does offer a lot of value and most of the core features that make a mechanical keyboard great, and this is why I would recommend it if it's what your budget allows. And as always, links to this item will be in the description if you want to check it out for yourself. So hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure you liked the video if you did, and if you didn't, just let me know why down below. Otherwise, don't forget to subscribe if you still haven't already, as I'll see you in the next video.